If you recite Surah Al-Baqarah, you will get these three things. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, my dear respected brothers and sisters, and salam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to our weekly hadith program. And this is the 16th hadith. We are still talking about the verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. Last two hadith, we talked about the verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, hadith 15th and hadith 14th. My advice is to go back to those hadiths. And today we will continue talking about the verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. Imam Muslim narrated from Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, اقرأوا سورة البقرة فإن أخذها بركة وتركها حسرة ولا تستطيعها البطلة. Recite سورة البقرة. For holding on to سورة البقرة is blessing, and to give it up is a cause of grief. Abandoning سورة البقرة is a source of regret, and magician cannot confront it. Evil people will not be able to overcome you. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, let us recite Surah Al-Baqarah. Let's hold on to Surah Al-Baqarah, because you will get blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know what does plus means? It means everything will be increased in its perfection and quality. Your health, your wealth, your life, not only that, and your family. I think from now on, you will not abandon Surah Al-Baqarah. You will hold on to this surah. Recite it. May Allah bless you. May Allah protect you. Jazakumullahu khairan. Barakallahu feekum. Don't forget to share it with your brothers, sisters, families, and friends. Jazakumullahu khairan. Barakallahu feekum. I love you for the sake of Allah. And I will see you next Sunday with a new hadith. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.